But the idea that I wanted us to kind of get through, and this was actually an idea proposed by Levin et al. In their paper, which is also referenced at the end of this lecture, and it'll be available for you to look at, is how can we actually create a coded aperture? So this is my conventional aperture, right? Just a opening. I know the size. I know the amount of light that it goes through. Can we actually create a mask, referred to as a code here, on the aperture plane that makes the defocus planes different when they actually register on the sensor? And if they're different, they might be easier to discriminate. So basically that suggests is we want to actually add a coded aperture, which basically lets in less light, but in a known pattern like this. What's the artifact of this? Let's look at exactly the example we looked at before of our lens and defocus. Remember, we had looked at this before. We basically had an object moved up, and of course it created these patterns from a single light source. So here, of course, we have an image of a defocus point light source. Of course, when we replace it, this will look different, right? Because now less light will come in. Of course, that basically says, how do we, what kind of build this is we now create obstructions on the lens. Like, I'm just going to show you one simple example here. Basically, how I'm going to represent these things are simple obstructions shown here. So basically, this line here is maybe considered to be one of these things. And I'm going to basically say, if I put an obstruction like this on the lens, basically means is now this part of the light is not making it to my sensor. And of course, that translates into a spread function that would be different. Similarly, I would actually put another one just to kind of see what the effect is. And again, that also goes in there. And translation is that, of course, now I have a point spread function that also has a different look, you know, maybe like this. This was the output based on this. Again, notice this is what we're trying to do here. The same object far away, putting simple two obstructions, we get a newer image or a newer output. But we can now start calibrating this. Recall again, we did this kind of same trick when we were talking about light field cameras. Again, simple example, further, same obstructions. I move the object closer. Spread function is different. Of course, now I can start calibrating for these types of things. As I move closer and closer, you can basically see at the end of it. Doesn't matter what it is, if I actually move the light source here, the spread function will come back to what I expected for a regular aperture, because this everything is in focus. Of course, the final one, when the object is at the focal plane, of course, the image is created here, our spread function is there. And while there might be a small impact off the obstructions here, for the full focus thing, you'll actually get a spread, the image to be much smaller, and a point spread function that will also be like the one we had expected in case when there was no obstructions.